Hi, I'm Akhil Kapoor. I'm working as a Chief Solution Architect looking after analytics in India. What we are showing here is insight-driven automated operations using analytics, machine learning, and AI. The different root causes analysis can be carried out, and given the orchestration and the platform availability within the operator, even the resolutions can be carried out automatically. Let me show it to you. For any kind of automation to work, there are certain insights which are needed. Insights which talks about experience per subscriber, per call, per session, and further, we can be segmented on a very important customers to enterprise impact. And secondly, the unique models, which basically captures a company know-how, its experience from global operations, is being embedded or enriched in the platform itself, which predicts a quality of experience issues and give actionable insights. Within that, a knowledge base is being built, again using neural networks with a root cause automation and next best actions. So basically, it's a knowledge base which is built in this platform, which provides all the different intelligence for a root cause analysis and resolutions to be done. And further, it has to have a flexibility and capability to have automation workflows to manage life cycle of all the quality of service and service level monitorings. Lastly, any kind of machine learning or AI system should have a continuous feedback from the actions it has taken and how the result is spent. So it's called reinforcement. Just to illustrate, here is across the data, an operator, within the operator data, all that is collected, analyzed. System is collecting the data in real time, carrying out the resource and service estimations or KPIs calculations for the subscribers in real time, and further embedded in the models. These models are being worked upon, then machine learning algorithms to have all the different insights. Insights which can be given to network, workforce and other teams for root cause analysis and resolutions. Ericsson has expert analytics platform which is multi-vendor, cross-domain and has the capability to take per subscriber sessions across radio, core and IMS. Basically with this, for every session ongoing in real time, it has a resource KPIs and service KPIs, which is being formed for a continuous data analysis for every sessions or every call which a subscriber plays. Then it has the unique models to have the incidents, to have the for like a voltage call drop or soft drops and other aspects like this. Commonalities such as cells, clusters, and so on and so forth. And finally, dynamic profiling for marketing. Like it's like, how is the user experience? What kind of cross-sell upsells can be carried out? Finally, above this, as I said, it's a unique models which predicts or which carry out the satisfaction index. Here we are looking at the subscriber level index, which tantamounts to his net promoter score. Besides this, there are probable causes and recommended actions which the system will provide, and the orchestration has to be done for its resolutions. Let me show one example. Here we are talking about automated operations. What we see in this illustration is the different quality of experience degradations across clusters and different actions which is triggered. As I said, it is real time. Look at these. These are voltage call drops which system is estimating. Henceforth, it is looking at different voltage call drops which across different severities. Let me illustrate to you a root cause action and resolutions. For example, a voltage call drop has every kind of network has a KPI to monitor. In this case, it's a voltage call drop. What we see in this case is the voltage call drop trend has increased, which is anomaly, which is detected by anomaly detection algorithms within the platform, expert analytics platform itself. Now, event is detected, which is anomaly. In this case, the call drop has increased. Then this root cause analysis steps are carried out. as I said in the start, for each subscriber, in real time, the sessions are being maintained by the platform. It's a big data analytics platform, which is in a way future-proof and scale-up. Then this carried out certain bucketizations and localization part, which is on root cause, on coverage, on interference and handovers. In this case, it's a handover aspect which is being talked about. If it's a handover, it looks at the requested PM and FM data. It looks at the statistical analysis and carry out a neural network, which I say random forest neural networks, to resolve the issue. The outcome is that this A3 offset was the root cause which was found out, which was impacting the handover. Basically, the voltage curve was dropping because the A3 offset timer was high. And system, with this knowledge base, identifies by itself with no manual involvement.